First, it is necessary to understand that what is compulsory voting. It is basically a system in which voters are obliged to vote. Actually, compulsory voting is not a new concept. It was first considered by the Parliament in 1950 at the time of the enforcement of the Representation of the People's Act. But on that time it was rejected due to the practical difficulties in implementation. Now there are many reasons why I am saying that practically it is not possible in our country. First, if voting made compulsory, then it will infringe the other rights of an individual, like right to freedom of speech and expression and many other rights. There are many reasons like that. Other reasons are that it creates the situation of donkey voting. Like voters were forced to vote. For example, in Australia, voters were forced to vote because if they don't vote, voters will pay fine to the government. So when we talk about the voting process, it is basically a concept that particular voter willfully come out from their home and cast the vote. But when it is forcible, then what is the meaning of that voting? It doesn't mean. And especially in a country like India, where we set the examples for other country in the terms of democracy. When we talk about right to vote itself gives us a right to refrain from voting. That means it depends from person to person, or it varies from individual to individual. There are 28 countries in which voting made compulsory. They are Belgium, Australia, Switzerland, and many others. But when we bifurcate these countries, 14 countries are very small countries. 6 countries move from strict to non-strict enforcement. 2 countries, Italy, Netherlands, fully abolish this provision. And remaining 6 countries also think about this. By seeing this bifurcation, it is very easy to assume that if it is not possible in a small country, then how it is possible in a big country like India, where we have a huge population of more than 140 crore people. Now, I am putting some facts, judgments and committee reports in front of you, which make it crystal clear that it is practically not possible in our country. In 1990, the Dinesh Goswami Committee rejected the proposal due to the practical implementation in its provision. In Tharkhandu Committee rejected the proposal and stated that their compulsory voting is not a way to increase the voter turnout, but there is a need to spread awareness among the people that they willfully come out from their home and cast the vote. In 2015, a PIL has been filed by a person named Satya Prakash, in which he told the Supreme Court for compulsory voting. But on that time, in response to the court, central government told to the Supreme Court that compulsory voting is a universal adult franchise for everyone, for every citizen, but it is not a duty. And the same thing is mentioned in the 255th Law Commission report, and also stated that it is compulsory voting is not a provision which needs to be encouraged. At the last, by seeing all these facts and figures, I want to tell or conclude that if voting made compulsory, then it will create problems for us. Actually, when we talk about for unfair practices, we also think about the corruption. There is a famous word for cash for vote is very much prevalent in our country, especially in a country like India, where this type of thing is very much. When we see other things, it is very, there is a need that we have to spread awareness, or there is a need to set the accountability of the individual or voter that they willfully come out from their home and cast their vote. Because we don't want a situation like Australia of donkey voting, where voters were forced and they vote. So at the last, when we vote, when we come out from the vote, This is a symbol which make us proud. But when we think about this in a fear manner, then it is a curse for us. At the last, I want to ask from all of you want freedom or restriction? Depends on you. Thank you.